Hey everybody, welcome back to the Black Link Experience. It's your girl Marva B. Subscribe, like, and share. Leave your comments below because your opinion does matter. And guess what? We're here for it. Hit that bell for notifications. Follow us on Instagram at Black Link Magazine. So we are gonna get off of Puffy for a minute and we're going to other things in the news. So Lizzo posted last night on Instagram that she is quitting the music business. She says the truth hurts. Singer went on to criticize the lies she says are being told about her. She says, but I'm starting to feel like the world doesn't want me in it, she continued. I'm constantly up against lies being told about me for clout and views. Lizzo is currently embroiled in a S harassment lawsuit filed by three of her former dancers. The lawsuit alleged Lizzo created a hostile work environment and S harassed employees, which the singer has denied. She is also facing another lawsuit from her former employee who alleges she allowed bullying, harassment, and racial discrimination on her team. So in her March 29th statement, which was last night, the singer went on to say that she is tired of being the butt of the joke every single time because of how I look, my character being picked apart by people who don't even know me, disrespecting my name. I didn't sign up for this, she concluded. I quit. So Lizzo, you know, when you get in this business, it's going to be a consistent, constant SHI, you know what show, and you have to have a backbone. And I know you get tired. I know you get tired. We are YouTubers and we just come out here and report stories and we are so judged and we don't get kind comments, you know, in our DMs or below in the comments. It's not always nice and we just have to push through it. And I know it's hard because you're a way much bigger celebrity than we are. So I know it could be triple the amount, but you just have to just hold on because people love your music. Despite of the things that are being said about you and what you're going through, we love your music. Hang in there. Lizzo changes course on body positivity. So in an interview published days ago by the New York Times about her clothing brand Yeezy's new shapewear influenced swimwear line, Lizzo did not seem to indicate that she was planning on leaving either the clothing or the music industry and declined to discuss the ongoing lawsuit. She touted Yeezy's new line and opened up about her weight, however, revealing that she has been losing weight very slowly. She noted that because she is not currently touring, she has more time for self-care. I'm taking the time every day to put some love into my body, she told the Times. There is never a day when I regret taking a walk or doing some Pilates. She added that how she feels about her body changes every single day. So ups and downs, I get it. I'm not going to lie and say I love my body every day, she told the outlet. There are some days I adore my body and others when I don't feel completely positive. Once a perceived champion of body positivity, she also revealed to the Times that she is more about body neutrality these days. The idea of body positivity, it's moved away from the antiquated mainstream conception, she said. It's evolved into body neutrality. So where does the lawsuit with three of her former backup dancers stand? Three of Lizzo's former backup dancers, Ariana Davis, Crystal Williams, and Noelle Rodriguez, filed a lawsuit in August 2023, alleging that the singer created a hostile work environment and harassed her employees. Lizzo denied all allegations against her in this suit, calling them false, unbelievable, and outrageous. The dancers' lawsuit also named dance captain Shirley Quigley and Lizzo's production company Big Girl Big Touring Inc. as defendants and alleged Quigley proselytized to the dancers and shamed those who engaged in premarital sex. Quigley called the accusations baseless and wrote in a February Instagram post that in due time, the truth will come out and I look forward to speaking that truth at the appropriate time. In February 2024, a judge in Los Angeles County Superior Court denied the singer's request to throw out the backup dancers' lawsuit. So Lizzo did file a motion to have it thrown out, and the judge has since denied it. So Judge Mark H. Epstein did elect to toss out some of the plaintiff's accusations against Lizzo and her team, including that Lizzo fat-shamed one of the dancers. So they threw that out. A spokesperson for Lizzo, Stefan Friedman, said in a statement at the time that the team is pleased that Epstein chose to throw out all or part of four of the plaintiff's causes of action. Lizzo is grateful to the judge for seeing through much of the noise and recognizing who she is, a strong woman who exists to lift others up and spread positivity, Freeman said. We plan to appeal all elements that the judge chooses to keep in the lawsuit and are confident we will prevail. Lizzo is also facing another lawsuit filed by a former employee, fashion designer Asha Daniels. In the lawsuit filed in Los Angeles County Superior Court in September 2023, Daniels says the musician allowed bullying, harassment, and racial discrimination on her tour. Daniels said in her lawsuit that wardrobe manager Amanda Nomura did offensive stereotypical impressions of Black women, referred to the performers as fat, useless, and dumb, and forced them to change in front of mostly white male stage crew. Friedman, Lizzo's spokesperson, told NBC News at the time of the filing that Daniels' lawsuit was a bogus, absurd publicity stunt lawsuit from someone who never actually met or even spoke with Lizzo. We will pay this as much attention as it deserves, the statement said. None. The lawsuit remains ongoing. So, you know, Lizzo is going through a lot as a celebrity, as a performer. And when you are a celebrity like that, the more money, more problems. And that's just the truth. And so she's a celebrity and she's catching it. She's catching it from all angles. And that is not to dismiss the allegations that are brought forth to her. A judge feels like those allegations are permissible and he will not choose to dismiss them. So there has to be some evidence or something that he feels like we've got to hear this case. So I can imagine with all of the lawsuits going on, with the way she's feeling about herself daily, she loves herself some days she doesn't, with all the things that she see on social media about herself that are not positive, it can weigh in on anyone. So we're just gonna say, we wish you the best of luck, Lizzo. We will be following the story to see the outcome of the lawsuits. In the meantime, we just pray that, you know, your self-confidence, you already have self-confidence, you're a beautiful girl. And we just hope that you can just hang in there. And if in fact what you're saying is not true, what you're saying is that you deny all allegation, that none of this is true. If that's a fact, just hold on, they'll get past it and you'll be fine. But just, you know, right now the allegations are out there. So you just have to go through the motions. Other than that, just keep your head up, hang in there, and we shall see the outcome because we will be following. We got our good eye on this case. You guys, this is the Black Link Experience. Subscribe, like, and share.